Welcome to the last session from ICCA Education for this Expo Culinaire. In this session, Chef Sabine Farid is going to demonstrate a gluten-free caramel pecan petit four. Sabine is an accomplished high tea chef, sweet and savory. And anyone who has visited ICCA for an event pre-COVID will know exactly what I'm talking about. Welcome, Sabine. We look forward to see what you have in store for us.
Thank you, Ms. Shanaz, for the beautiful prelude. Good afternoon and welcome to ICCA Live. Today we are presenting a gluten-free dessert in the form of a petit gâteau called caramel pecan. The demand for gluten-free desserts, lactose-free desserts, vegan desserts is definitely on the high now. And this recipe has been specially crafted for this occasion to cater to this sector. A dessert in the form of petit gâteau is, of course, an ongoing trend nowadays as well. So let's get going with the production of our dessert. I have with me Chef Julita from ICCA Dubai, who's preparing the recipe with me. Okay. We have a couple of components in this dessert adorning this petit gâteau. There is the pecan custard in which the other components are going to be enclosed. So let's start. We have over here a mix that we've pre-prepared. This is our gluten-free flour mix. This consists of nothing but our buckwheat flour, our rice flour, and our corn flour. Buckwheat flour, though the name is buckwheat, is not even closely related to wheat. It is a gluten-free flour, high in potassium, vitamin B, and of course caters to the need of the gluten-free aspect. So we have combined these three flours together, and this is the blend that we are going to use in all our dry goods like the sablé or the sponge. So the first item that we are preparing is our caramel sponge. We have over here, pre-prepped from before, a dry caramel that we had made. And when the dry caramel was weighed, we added to it the gluten-free flour mix, about 45 grams of the gluten-free flour mix. And we added to that some chopped pecans. When the recipe will be enclosed to you, you will be able to see the quantities. Now to this mixture, I'm going to add in the eggs. And I'm just going to fold it in. The preparation of the caramel is a little time consuming, and hence we skip that step. But it's just a dry caramel that we are achieving. Once we fold in our eggs, what we have done over here is we have some egg whites and invert sugar, which we have whisked together to firm peak to form this meringue. And I'm now going to mix this caramel and yolk mixture to my whipped egg whites. I'm going to gently fold that in. And with that, the batter for my caramel sponge will be ready. This will bake at 160 degrees Celsius in a 10 centimeter to a 14 centimeter ring. And then it will be used to cut out for the dessert, as the dessert will be molded in a silicone mold. So we are done with this. So this is one of our used sponges where we have the sponge beneath. And on top of that, we have the soft caramel. I'll go ahead and explain a little about the soft caramel now. So this is our soft caramel, which we have pre-prepared from before. Again, we have made a dry caramel and we have just added to that. We have added liquid glucose to that while making the dry caramel after that. And then we have added some salt. We've added some cocoa butter. We've added as well some caramel chocolate and we whisk that in. We whisk that in till we achieve such a consistency. This soft creamy caramel will go on top of our baked cake to accompany the second layer. We move on to our third component, which is our pecan crunchy sablé. So our petit gâteau will rest on this particular biscuit. Thank you, Julita. So we have over here some butter and some muscovado sugar, which we are going to beat together, cream together. Once I'm done creaming this mixture, I'm going to just fold in some chopped pecans and the same gluten-free flour mix that we had explained when we started off. Once mixed in thoroughly, I'm going to form this into a slab and I'm going to sheet it thin between two silicone sheets. I won't waste time mixing that. We don't overmix our dough. We're going to sheet it thin between two silicone sheets and we are going to freeze this till it is nice and firm. We're going to then cut out 5 centimeter discs of this sablé to act as the base of our dessert. This will then freeze again. After the discs are cut, it will then freeze again till it's nice and firm, if it has at all defrosted, and it will bake at 160 degrees for about 5 to 6 minutes. After it is baked, it will look something like this. The discs will look something like this. So it's indeed a great treat for the gluten-free sector, where this delicious crisp pastry and crisp the sponge, which is also made from the gluten-free flour mix, is available to them for them to relish. All right, so we will move on to our next component, which is our pecan custard. So as I said, we have our dessert. The primary component is our pecan custard. And then we have our sponge, our caramel sponge, and our caramel, which is attached to it, enclosed within. And we have one more yet component coming onto it, which I will just reveal. So this is nothing but a creme anglaise, a custard, whereby we have simply heated the milk and tempered the egg yolk with it. And then we have gone ahead to, I'll fold in the rest of the ingredients just in front of you. I'm adding to this some pecan paste. It's a small recipe. That's why the quantity seems so minimal. In case if anybody desired to keep this eggless, we can make a custard by heating up the milk and mixing it with the sugar as per desire, and some corn flour or some custard. So that would be your eggless custard. And simply you would go ahead by following the steps like we are doing now. Here I have some semi-whipped cream, which I'm also going to fold in into the custard now. Thank you, Julita. So I'm just going to fold this in and our pecan custard is ready. We have one last component, which I have yet to show, and then we'll talk about the assembly. But before that, we'll take a short break. welcome back yet again. So here I have folded in my cream into my pecan custard, and I'm just going to pour it into a piping bag. So this is the mold, silicone mold, that we have used for assembling our dessert. However, you can use as per your desire. So first and foremost, I'm going to pipe in some of the custard, about 1/3 of the custard mixture. And then I'm going to set it in the blast freezer for it to set to accompany to welcome the other component coming in. So let's talk about the next component. It is our passion fruit jelly. We have over here our passion fruit puree, some fresh passion fruit, about 2 or so of those, and we have some corn flour. We're just going to bring it up to a boil. Once it comes to a boil, we have pre-soaked some gelatin over here, which we're going to add to that. Just adding the cornstarch. So once that comes to a boil, I'm going to add in the soaked gelatin to combine and to dissolve. And then I'm going to let it cool for a while. And I'm going to use it to pipe on top of my pecan custard. So as I was saying, that this is a jelly that is accompanying the dessert. Any preferred jelly can be added onto the dessert, be it raspberry or be it strawberry, or any preference of your choice would actually blend well with pecan. It's a neutral nut, so to say. So now this has come to a boil. I'm going to add in the gelatin. I'm going to remove the excess water. And I'm going to add in the gelatin to dissolve. And whilst finishing this component, we are actually done with all the components of our dessert. All right, we can remove it from the heat, Chalita. And probably we can just pour it into one of our glasses. I'm going to add a thin layer of the jelly on top of my pecan custard and let it freeze. Thank you. So as evident over here, that's coming in the camera, yeah. This is one of the pre-done desserts. We have the pecan custard beneath. On top of that, we have the passion fruit jelly layer. And on top of that, we have cut out the cake and the caramel layer. And we've added that in. Now what's remaining for this is just some more of the pecan custard to enclose the dessert. Tap to remove any air bubbles, and this can go in the blast freezer. I won't be adding this now, it's a little hot. We'll have to wait it to cool to add it, and plus this layer has not set as of now. We'll add this to the blast. So having done that, we are now ready to do the final reveal of our dessert. So here I have my gluten-free caramel pecan petit gâteau, where we have the sablé right beneath, and we have the dessert sitting right on top of the sablé, along with certain embellishment garnishing the dessert. Hope you enjoyed this session. What we have also done is that we have sprayed our petit gâteau with a cocoa butter spray. We have given it a red velvet finish. However, any color of preference, even a chocolate spray, can be done to embellish this dessert. Secondly, we can also make a quick caramel glaze to embellish the dessert as well.
Cracker, the McAvoy's wife.
Any questions, Ms. Shanaz, during the webinar? Do we need to answer any questions? Do we have any doubts from any of our audience?
Not really, Sabine, but I am amazed at your dessert. It looks so yummy and lovely. I'm so sorry. And I introduced it. I was a petit four. I knew I did something wrong. It was a petit gâteau. Sorry. Anyway, Sabine,
I could have signed it off for you, but anyway.
Just
yeah,
see what's hiding inside.
Mike's bloody calling me again.
Okay, so I had that was Chef Andy's voice coming through. I muted it.
Yeah.
It looks like you've joined two molds together, two of those spheres together to make one petit gâteau. Is that right?
No. It's one mold itself where we've assembled the dessert in layers. It's just one mold.
Oh, but it looks round, but that one looked like semicircular. So I thought probably you put two together.
Yeah, it's a complete hemisphere-like.
Ah, okay. Fine, okay. Looks yes. Lovely. And I would like you to cut it and give us a peek into it. I think that's really very important to see the inserts, the layers. And I think this frame, this particular style of making desserts is trending now, and this is what you get everywhere. Can you remove that the nut in the front?
Yes.
Yeah, now we can see.
So we have our pecan custard, we have our caramel sponge, we have our soft creamy caramel, and we have our jelly to accompany this dessert. Indeed, it's a very tasty variation of a gluten-free delight. And I would request you all to try as you get the recipe cards with you to enjoy this yet again.
Thank you, Sabine. That was such a lovely dessert. And I do know you're pressed for time. Otherwise, you would have showed it to us in more detail. But not to worry, we will come back with many more webinars from ICCA all through Ramadan.